Hey, what's up guys, Indian Sensei here. Welcome to another episode of Ninja Voltage, and in this video we are gonna look at the new 4 star which we got from the Sam number 24 for 6 part Naruto, which is a very awesome 4 star. I mean, it is has the, as of now in this game, has the highest range in clearing traps. I mean, I'm talking about the range per se, not in single direction like Hokage Naruto or Minato reanimation Shadow Clone Jutsu. But overall range, I mean, it has a very huge range, you will see in the video. So, and also the power level of my current Naruto might be a little bit more or less from the video, because I recorded the video earlier, yesterday I think. So the power levels might be a little different, but the not that much. I mean, they were both A ranks. I think this one is higher than the video. I don't know. Rest of the stuff is still the same, I think. Not that much of a difference. So let's just see how he performs in attack mission. I will be taking KLM and Rin and Rin Sasuke with me as support characters. So yeah, let's jump into the video. So guys, this is our first game, and looks not that good. I mean, he could have shifted his characters around here and there, and this would have been a good base, but I don't know. Let's see. But he has Rin in the final room, so let's try it out. I could have used Hashirama instead of Rin Sasuke, but the problem is I haven't maxed out Hashirama's all 4 stars yet. So yeah, I am using Rin Sasuke, and I can keep the team together with my trap clearing jutsu, so no problem. I mean, look at the range. A very, I mean, not a single line range, just a huge area. I'm not sure, but I think 5x5 square of range, maybe more. So let's see, we have Madara. Yeah, Madara. So let's try to seal him. And he's going down easily, because you can see I have the attack buff from Rin and the critical buff from KLM as well. So not going to be that much of a problem. I really love the range on the trap killing jutsu. I mean, look at that. Two jutsu, you just use two times and the whole room is clear. I think I should go right. Yeah, I should go right, because all the other shinobis are on the right, so I must go right. I think we have Danzo in the rightmost room. Let's see. Okay. So he is there, and I don't even need to do anything, alright? Just look at that. I mean, I'm basically just carrying my team and they are doing the stuff for me. And we have Obito here, and I think he should be done. Yeah, I don't know what is happening. Either my characters are too OP, or the characters in the base are too very low power. I don't know. Guys, stop, guys. They just see a wall and they just want to destroy it with their jutsus. They don't know how to chill. Okay, let's see. If I remember correctly, we have in the right corner, I don't remember who. I think KLM. Okay, I cannot see him. I'm just doing randomly here. I think he's around. Yeah, he's dead. Ooh, so that was nice. As you can see, critical and attack buff still going on. So that was bound to happen with any shinobi we encounter, because the team is too OP, man. I mean, Hashirama would be good too, because he would have sealed and stuff, but this team is also not bad. I mean, two of the characters are SS tier support, Rin and KLM. So okay, this doesn't work from here. I should use it from here. Maybe I will. No, I cannot seal him from here. Maybe I could. What? Did you look at that? I mean, Rin Sasuke just used his Chidori once, and Itachi version 1 was dead. That was insane. I didn't know how much damage did he did.
Okay. Oh man, look at the chakra. Okay. 281 chakra, but I still have to. I mean, I need like 100 more, so I will try to get damage so that Rin will heed me. Rin. I will just kill this Rin, because if she uses her ultimate, then it's going to be a problem. And I think I have 500 chakra. Oh! They. What? Man, I didn't get to see how did they kill everyone. Anyways, this attack mission was not much of a showcase. I mean, I just cleared traps for them and they did all the job. So basically my team carried me. So let's try one more, and I will try to not be carried this time.
Okay, second attack mission, and Genghis Khan. Okay. Nah, less scrolls. Man, I just keep getting one scroll. So anyways, we will have to manage with this one. Okay, let's see. Rin is Sasuke. SO6P with the Genjutsu trap. Okay. Okay. If KLM uses Roar, then it's good. Otherwise, it's going to be a problem. It would have been better if he put SO6P Naruto in the middle room with the reanimation summon. Summon, because otherwise he can die pretty easy. So let's clear the traps, and no tornado trap, that's unusual. On the left, who we have? Okay, we don't have any shinobi on the left, I think just the ninjas here. And I have the new installation on my head, as you can see the time thing, it will give me confusion. Okay, 3 seconds, I think 2-3 seconds confusion. Yeah. Okay, Sasuke, let's get seal, and I have the critical from the KLM, and he's dead. Easy peasy. Okay, I still have a lot of chakra, so it's good. 3000 is decent. Okay, let's clear the traps. How come he doesn't have any tornado traps here? He should have. Why don't he? He doesn't want to get enemy separated. What kind of strategy is this? So let's go to SO6P room, and hopefully KLM uses the roar. And no. And yeah, that was. Oh no. Finally roar. Okay, let's. Okay, so I was saying that he should have put a reanimation in the center, because with the Genjutsu trap, this would have worked pretty nicely there. And Madara, no problem again. He belongs to the final room, not in the defense, because if anyone comes with the full team, Madara is not going to be that much of a problem. Okay, the other room now. How should I enter? Can you see that he has installation here, and it's bound to give me some kind of effect? And what it gave me? Paralysis, man, that's the worst. But my team will manage somehow. Yeah, Sasori, not big of a deal. So let's see, who was in the right corner? I don't remember. Okay, I think it was EMS. So let's see. Okay, seal here. Yeah, seal again. I should move back because my team will handle it for me. Let's go. We have lot of time and we have lot of chakra. Yeah, so that's nice. Unless we don't lose some on the way, but I think I cleared most of the traps here, so I don't need to worry about the traps here. Let's go straight to the final room. Okay, none here. There would be some here, yeah. Okay, there was a heal, but I don't need it because I have full HP. All of my teammates have full HP, so let's just go and handle the final room. And he doesn't have tornado traps here as well. I mean, what's going on? Okay, he has here some. Three, okay. The range. Look at the range, man. It's so awesome. Let's just confirm. Yeah. I knew there was one more. Okay, so we are good to go from now. Okay, I don't remember if he has Rin or not. I don't think so. He has Rin. He has Hashi. Okay, let's easy peasy. None of those guys have iframes, so this was easy. So finally I was able to showcase him as a good attack mission. I mean, in the previous attack mission I just got carried away. So this time we managed a good amount of CP till the final room. So yeah, looks nice. So we played like two games, and the first game I barely did anything there. I mean, the team carried me. I just cleared the traps for them and I didn't keep check of my CP. But in the second game, I tracked my CP as much as possible. So I had pretty high CP with me. So I was able to win that one pretty easily. So the team though is very awesome. The team, I don't know if I could solo with him as of now, because in the current fortresses, we have lot of shinobis who are problematic, like Kabuto. I mean, if you see a Kabuto, you just need to ult, because if you hesitate in killing Kabuto, then it might be very dangerous for you as well as your team. So soloing, I'm not sure if I can solo. I am not a good attack player. So maybe people can do solo with him if you are talented. I mean, if you have the skills. I don't clearly have the skills to do solo with him yet, but hope maybe if he get with the new 60-second cooldown ultimate, maybe I can solo with him too. So as of now, he is a pretty, I mean, I don't know if the tier list got updated or not, but according to me, he is definitely SS tier as a main character. So with the 4 star, of course, he became SS tier. So yeah, so also I will try to max out Hashirama's new 4 stars and see, try to make a video for him as well. So yeah, but the main problem with this jutsu is the CP cost is way too high. I mean, look, 100 CP cost. Let's look at some other shadow clone jutsu of Edo Minato. Let's look at him. Where it is? Yeah. So look at that. Yeah, I mean 30. Although he is a red character, the CP cost is way too low. So 30 is, I mean, the CP cost on 6-path Naruto's 4 star could have like be 50-60, but 100 is too high, even for a blue character. The Sage Art Lava Style also has 130 CP, and this Rasengan also has 100 CP. So CP cost is little high, although he's a blue character, but since he has to use these jutsu frequently, most of all this trap clearing jutsu, so it should have been a low CP cost jutsu. But anyways, if they would have made this 50 CP cost, then that would be a very problematic for everyone, because he would become very 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 OP. So yeah, so I hope you guys like the video, and stay tuned for the Hashirama video as well. I will try to max out all his 4 stars and make him make a video for him as well. So yeah, until then, sayonara.